Well, from a city that normally gets only about 20 inches of snow a year, they're getting a pretty good wallop right now as we're at M&T Bank Stadium in Baltimore, Maryland. Coming up, we've got a good matchup on tap between the Detroit Lions and the Baltimore Ravens. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. A play fake for Swift, now Goff. That's out to the flat for Swift. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. Give him three there on the first play of the game, and it's second down.
Our defense is worried that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
Looking to throw again on second down. Goff got his man. It's Williams. Goff and Williams hooking up there for Lions first.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
They'll run for the first time with DeAndre Swift. And he'll get this out to about the 40. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and four.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
The last run got six, now second and four. There's goal. That's to Armin Rossing Brown. And he'll be tackled on the other side of midfield at the 46-yard line. So in Raven territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 46. A shotgun snap for goal. Now a loose football. The ball comes out, and they will set up sharp at their own 41-yard line. Baltimore with good starting field position as they come up first and 10 at the 41-yard line. The drive will commence with a run by J.K. Dobbins. 9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a second and one. And you often say that sort of opens the playbook now, second and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while, because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
The previous run, good for 9. Here's second and a yard. Jackson going to look to run with it. He'll wind up getting 2 there as he does it himself and picks up the first. So that was all you're looking for in a play like that. Get the first down and keep the drive moving.
Yeah, it just looked to me like he just said to himself, I got this. I'll take it. I'll pick it up and let's keep moving. Get the first down, get a new set, and let's start over.
On first and 10, it's Dobbins. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
I really like the vision he displayed on that play because he saw there wasn't a way to completely break off a huge game. So he found where there was the most space and got what he could. A nice, dirty run that's a positive play for the offense.
And now Jackson will look to throw it. That ball caught. It's Mark Andrews, the tight end. And the tackle going to be made at the 38.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
Could be 4 down territory even if they don't get this, but they need just a few inches here on third. They'll try to run for it with Dobbins. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. The Ravens get a new set of downs, give them 17 on that pickup. You were telling me this yesterday. It's exactly what they want to do on the open drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation. We were talking about where one of the GMs in the league has told me repeatedly, it's a big man's game. And it's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get leverage, knock people back, and establish the run early.
Now Jackson, and this is incomplete. He had 6 points right in his hands, but could not hang on.
even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
On second down, a run to Dobbins. They get six. That'll leave him with third and four.
He had to fight for every yard on that run. Shook himself free of the tackle and kept fighting. Even the rest of the defense closing in on it. That's the kind of effort you'll take every single time.
This will be the eighth play of the drive here. Third and four. Jackson. Throwing up and it's complete. And the Ravens are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. Really been an ideal start for them. They get the turnover on the opening possession. Now here they are moving the ball straight down the field on their first drive.
And that feels good, but you know on their side of the field, all they're thinking is, finish this drive off because they took it away, right? So now you got them back on their heels a little bit. Now go down, put a touchdown out on them. Look out. You've won the mental battle early in the game, and that may carry over for you.
2 yards the gain on the keeper, and it's second down.
I think that's the type of run we'll continue to see throughout this game. The snow coming down, I don't expect a lot of big plays to be broken.
They go option right on second and goal. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. No score after one on EA Sports. Second quarter now from Baltimore. It's the Ravens in possession. This has been a long drive. You got to figure a field goal would be a letdown. Can they convert now on third and goal? Escaping the pressure right. And he's just going to throw this one out of bounds here. Nowhere to go with it. Incomplete. So it's been a long drive. They've held the ball for quite a while. Now what do you do here?
Well, to me, at this stage after this drive, this close to the goal line, 3 points would be a letdown. I'm going for it here.
So Jackson will head to the Ravens sideline, and on comes Justin Tucker for the field goal try. From the right hash, and this one just a chippy. Tucker's kick is good, and the Ravens strike first and brings in. So pretty good opening drive. They'll make the Ravens fans somewhat happy. They wanted six, but they got three in the early
game. They should be happy. The guys look good getting down the field. That's got to give them a little bit of hope. The good things are in store here today.
Set to kick it away. The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. To throw is gone. Throw over the middle, he finds Williams. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. An excellent way to start the drive there, 18 yards.
Certainly no settling into the drive there. They came right out on the first play and attacked the middle of the field for a big gainer and a first down.
One play has him up past the 40 already and another first and 10. Goff now looks to throw. He's airing it out for Williams. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
They've been schemed going 5 wide, trying to create a chance for the big shot, and they took it. If he comes down with that, that's a huge offensive swing. But credit the defense with a nice play, knocking that one away.
So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Goff a handoff here to Swift. And across midfield it goes into Raven territory. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with 3rd and 1.
Okay, they bring that one all the way out, but you got to know that he feels like he's right on the verge. That's probably exactly what he's telling them in the huddle right now.
So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. Now a play fake, and it's gone. Rolling to his left. And connecting here with DJ Shark. And he's going to be taken down with the first down at the Ravens' 32-yard line. His first catch, and it's a pretty big one. They get the conversion on third down.
Well, this is an awfully tough route to defend in man coverage because he lines up on the right and runs a crossing route back to the other side of the field. So as a defender, you're not only trailing him the whole way, you're also looking out for your own guys to make sure you don't get yourself picked off. And then you can't catch up in time to prevent the
touchdown, Detroit. And what a St. Brown, 32 yards. And the Lions have taken the lead. And a nice job by him to catch the slant and then navigate and break free.
And receivers love slant routes because it gets the ball in their hands so quickly and oftentimes on the move. When they're on the move like that, then they get to use their best asset, which is usually their speed.
And their speed sometimes, like this instance, can take it into the end zone. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This one fielded out to five. And it won't quite make it to the 25. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it. Forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put six on the board. That's a consolation prize. I go to the county fair. You don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material. To throw on second and 10. Jackson looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Andrews. He'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of six.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
Now we're complete to Crochet. And he gets this up to the 34 outbounds there. First connection there of the afternoon for those two, and it's good for a first down.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. It's a pickup of 11 and a Baltimore first down.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus. And indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
Edwards now on first and 10. And this will be good for a pickup of 9 to the 46.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? And the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
The last run got 9. That leaves him with 2nd and a yard. Now it's Jackson. That's complete. Left side to Bateman. And he's going to be taken down right at the 40-yard line. Jackson to Bateman there. First down, Ravens. Jackson on first down. And he opens. clever shot in there. It's out of bounds, incomplete.
This defense started with a nice stand from this defense now after getting walked backwards on this drive.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Now it's Jackson. And he'll slide to a halt here. Still a little shy of the first down marker. 6 yards there off the scramble, but it'll still leave him with a third down.
They made a nice effort to stick it with a loss for that play, but it's going to take more than that to keep him from advancing the ball. Should be an entertaining battle anytime he tucks and runs over the second half of this contest.
From the gun on third down, Jackson. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down.
Oh, man. Just when the team thought they had the answer for it, he went and changed the question. Surprises him by taking off himself. He's able to set up his offense pretty with a first and goal.
So it's first and goal, and a great opportunity to get that lead back before the break. Jackson now. Toward the pylon, caught. And in for the Ravens touchdown. James Trochet from 8 yards out. And the Ravens will take the lead here in the final minute of the first half. That could be an important swing right there. Touchdown in the final minute of the half to take the lead.
And I like the point you just made there. Could be an important swing because now that they have the lead, if they can carry that into the locker room at the half, they feel really good about what they accomplished in the first 2 quarters.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And there will not be a return here. It's a touchback, and it will come down to the 25-yard line. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And with a little under a minute to go, they may try and work their way into field goal range and try to tie up this ball game. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. The Lions now taking over late in this first half. And with great starting field position and a couple of timeouts at their disposal, they'll certainly have the green light here. One play has them up past the 40 already and another first and 10. Now it's gone. Across the middle, he's got it complete to St. Brown. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Goff now to throw. Just get rid of him.
And now the common sight, at least on this drive, a momentary setback though for this passing game that has been moving well this series. Good thing for them though. Still two more downs to connect and try to pick up another first down.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. To the air again, Goff. That'll be caught by St. Brown. And he's going to have a first down here. They're also in a field goal range now at the 27-yard line.
I know we just saw a nice throw and catch, but how about the big guys up front buying that time? Yeah, that's exactly what they did. They created time and allowed the space to happen, and it turned into a really nice play.
Now the timeout signal for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now. They try to get three before halftime. This from 44 yards out, left hash. Badgley's kick is good, and that will knock us up at 10. So they're able to make things level just before half and also leave very, very little time on the clock.
And I love the way that you phrased that. Put a little soccer into it, and that's really apropos considering they just kicked a field goal to tie things up.
As the kick's away. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll be brought down right on the chalk of the 20. No reason to do anything foolish as they'll snap it one more time on first down. He'll take the knee and the final couple seconds will tick by in this first half. So thanks to the late field.